Hi everybody, here we go with part four of my Kickstarter campaign stuff for Zombicide Black Plague. What I'm going to show you this time, I'm going to quickly go over these items here, and then we'll have a more in-depth look at the miniatures that come in the Huntsman pack. So hopefully my camera will, the light on the camera will stay on. But first of all, we have the 3D doors. I'm not going to take them out of the box. You can basically see what they are. Got three different types of door. There's 27 in total. And you've got the different coloured bases for the different objectives in certain missions. We'll need a little bit of paint on them just to make them stand out a little bit more. Got a dice bag. This is like a velvety type bag. Feels quite nice to the touch. It's a good thing for putting your keeping your dice in when you're not playing. Here we have the dice tower. Exactly the same as what you got with Zombicide itself, so it's just a different colour. And inside you have two different stickers, either the base game artwork or the Wolfsburg artwork, which you just place straight on the back there. So nothing spectacular so far. Next we have the card holders. Now you get four card holders in here. You get two yellow and two red. They each hold, I think, about 190 cards each. So you have to put them together. But if you've got both Zombicide and this game as well, you're probably going to need to buy another box of these, because there's a hell of a lot of cards. It's a great idea anyway, it stops the cars from flying all over the place. Next we have three sets of dice. You've got the black dice. Got the flame there, which represents a six, and the zombie head represents a one. Also got the bone dice. And a set of red dice. They didn't release as many different coloured dice in this Kickstarter as they did in the normal Zombicide. Here we have the plastic tokens. These replace the cardboard ones that you get in the game. There's 62 tokens in total. These bits here at the bottom, one of the abominations can smash through walls. So these will represent that on the board. Quite thick plastic as well. You've got the first person token there as well. Dragon Ball, all the spawn sites, everything you need. There's enough there for you to be able to play the game quite easily. Don't really need another pack of these. I'm not going to take these out. You can see what they are. Basically, this video is mainly to show off this, which is the Huntsman pack. The miniatures inside here are either Kickstarter exclusives or some of the stretch goals that you get. And inside, if we open it up, there's two trays of miniatures and a couple of other little things in there. So before we come on to the actual miniatures themselves, we'll take a look at some of the cards. All you get is you get some spawning cards. Now you've got Evil Troy, which can be used as either a necromancer, which is why you've got this card, or you can use him as a hero as well. It's entirely up to you. And you've got Queen Medea, who is based on Charlize Theron from the Snow White and the Huntsman movies. So you just have, I think it's about four or five spawn cards for each of these two characters. So these are the two new necromancers that you can use. So before we move on to the heroes, we'll take a look at the zombie miniatures on the first tray. These are different sculpts for the NPC zombies, which are basically the VIP zombies. So you've got a priest. Really nice detailing again on these miniatures. You get four of those. You get an extra abomination, It's not a different sculpt. This is, I think, if I remember rightly, this is exactly the same sculpt as the one you get in the base game. This is a second Necromancer. Again, this is exactly the same sculpt as the one you get in the base game, but it's always handy to have an extra one because you do spawn a few of them from time to time. But the detailing is really nice on these miniatures. And here is the new Necromancer. This is the Queen, which is obviously Charlize Theron. So you have a choice of a female necromancer if you wish to use her. Before we come on to the actual heroes, we'll take a look at the second tray. You've got a set of, it says black dice, but they are actually brown. You can see that there on the viewfinder. You also get a set of white bases. These are so you can distinguish the NPC zombies. And here is the first player marker, which is metal. Exactly the same as the one you get in that pack there. And underneath is you've got the dice bag, exactly the same as that dice bag. So you've got some extra zombies here. So we'll go through them one at a time. Here we have another NPC zombie. This is based on Snow White. So you get four of those. Here's an extra runner. I think it looks like exactly the same sculpt as you get with the original game. You get two of those runners, and you get two of these runners, which is the hooded runner. Much better sculpts than the original zombie side. A little bit more put into them. Next up we have another type of walker, another female walker. And here's another male walker. This is just a few little extras just to add to your core game, because you will run out of walkers. There's another female, different type. And I'll put these two out together. Two different male walkers. Then you get four new fatties. So you've got this sculpt here, which is the one holding all his stomach in. So you get two of those, and you get two of these type fatties, which again, I think they are exactly the same as the base game. But it's always handy to have more. You get these NPC zombies. You get four of these. These are the zombie holding his head. And you get this guy, which is the abomination for the zombie wolves. Exactly the same sculpt as you get in the base game again. And finally, you get three different sculpts of extra wolves. So you get three different wolves just to add to the Wolfsburg expansion. Got that type, this type, And this type. These guys are nasty in the game. They get three activations. Exactly the same as the zombie dogs in the original zombie side. So that's the bottom tray. That's all the zombies. We'll now take a look at the heroes. You might recognise a few. Here's the first one. This is Hitch, which is obviously based on David Bowie from the movie Labyrinth. Now, I think this figure is going to go up in price. It's going to be quite pricey, mainly because, unfortunately, he died this year. And this was actually made before his death. So it's going to be worth a bit of money. Quite a few of these heroes to go through. Here we have Lady Faye. Not sure who she is. I think she is based on Kristen Stewart from Snow White and the Huntsman, and obviously the Twilight movies. But I think that's who this is supposed to be. Next up we have Lucas. Not sure who this is. I'm sure somebody will be able to tell me. Just trying to get through this video fairly quickly before the light on the camera goes. Because when it does, you won't be able to pick out the detail as much. Just move these cards to one side because they seem to be focusing on that. Here we have James, which is Sean Connery again, so he makes a second appearance in the zombie side game. He was in the original. Then we have Morgan. Don't know who that is supposed to be. I suppose you could use this guy as a necromancer as well if you wish. Come on, camera. I don't know why it keeps focusing on my hands rather than the miniature. Next up we have Zuxa, which is obviously Xena Warrior Princess. Probably going to be quite a few people's favourites for playing. No Chakra though on her waist, so she hasn't got the throwing disc that she had in Xena. Maybe licensing won't let them do that. Makes it too obvious. And I do believe the Xena series is coming back again. So, a little bit of information for you there. Here we have William. Again, he looks like somebody I should know, but I can't tell you who it is offhand. Again, put comments below if you know who they are. Got about 3 or 4 minutes before my light goes off. Here we have Gilbert, which I believe is one of the knights from Monty Python and the Holy Grail. Not one of the better looking miniatures, this one. I suppose when he's painted up it'd be completely different, but he's not particularly a figure that would give you that wow factor. It's got quite a bit of burr on there as well that needs to come off. Next up we have Falstaff, which is Vlad the Impaler, or Dracula, from the Ridley Scott movie. Trying to get the camera to stay focused, it's difficult, but I hope it's coming out okay. Here we have Paul. Again, he looks familiar, but I'm not sure who he's supposed to be. If the camera doesn't focus, we're never going to see who's going to be. Here we go, that's better. I am looking at getting a new camera very soon, so hopefully my videos will be a bit better. Here's Danton, which is obviously William Wallace, aka Mel Gibson from Braveheart. Nice miniature. Again, probably quite a few people's favourites for playing, purely for the character himself. Here we have Bob, which I think is Christopher Lee. I could be wrong. Another wizard. Again, you could use him as a necromancer if you so wish. Getting to the end now. Here we have Evil Troy, which is basically Evil Ash from the Evil Dead. Now this is the guy that you can, that has cards to be used as a necromancer if you wish, but you can also use him as a hero. Next up we have Montalban, which is another of the, I think another one of the knights from the Monty Python's Holy Grail. Next up we have Troy, who is obviously Ash from the Evil Dead. And he made an appearance in the original Zombicide as well, as the same, in the same name as well, Troy. So it was a no-brainer really that he was gonna appear in this one. It's obviously Bruce Campbell plays him. Come on, camera focus. Here we go. There's two more to go. Pippa. Not 100% sure who this is. I'm surprised they haven't done anybody from Game of Thrones, actually. Or maybe they have, and I've just missed it. And the final one is Mortimer, which again is one of the knights from Monty Python and the Holy Grail. So yeah, there you go. That's it for this video. In part 5, we will be mainly looking at the night pack and some of the special guest boxes, and then in part six will be the rest of the special guest boxes. So it'll all be miniatures from now on. I just wanted to get these ones out of the way on this video. So there's nothing special there, but it's the miniatures that you want to see. So hopefully this will give you some sort of idea whether you want to, if you haven't got these for your game, if you want to go onto eBay and maybe try and buy a few. So as always, thanks for watching. Sorry it's a bit naff camera work, but I'm a bit pressed for time today, so I've had to rush through it. I want to get these videos out and done over the next week to 10 days if I can, because I want to start on something else after that. So until my next video, as always, thanks for watching and see you later.